his daddy?
Hello. I've known I'm over 600, but I'm just not sure how far over I am now. And my big worry is that I could see something that surprises me on the scale. And that would really be discouraging if that happens.
Now we're going to room 5.
Okay. That's about what I expected, so I'm glad I haven't gained a lot more. But I'm still not happy about that number. It's just not a number that's supposed to be associated with a human. And it's embarrassing that my family sees that and knows that's me. You know that's how big I am, because people don't get to this weight. But I'm here to change that. So hopefully, this is the last time I see a scale number that high, and that it just starts going down from here because of the help I get today. I've needed that for a long time, and I'm ready to change. I just need to know how to do it and get that push I need from Dr. Now.
Hello, how y'all doing?
Good, how are you?
Okay. I'm Dr. Nazar, and you must be Krystal.
Yes.
And who is with you?
Breedlin.
Good to meet you all.
Nice to meet you as well, Dr. Now.
All right. Where are y'all coming from?
Ohio.
Ohio. Where in Ohio?
Frankfurt.
All right. I'll take you from Ohio to come down to Houston.
It took us 2.5 days.
2.5 days?
Yes.
Wow. That's quite a trip. So what brought you down to Houston?
Hopefully you can help me change my life.
And how are you going to change your life?
Lose weight.
So
get the bypass surgery.
Okay. So you're 34 and 618 pounds?
Yes.
All right. So what seems to be challenges with your eating habit?
I'm a binge eater.
Binge eater all day?
It's an everyday thing.
So were you able to motivate yourself and change that?
Yes.
You think you can do that?
I believe I can. It's time for me to take care of me instead of everyone else. It's time for me to focus on me instead of the rest of my family. You know, focus on me and my little family here and instead of taking care of everyone else. It's time for me.
Well, it's a typical day. Just walk me through what you eat and what you do all day. So when you wake up in the morning, what time you wake up?
I usually wake up about 11, 11:30.
11, 11:30, okay.
A.M.
Okay.
Take my medicine, drink a couple cans of pop, diet pop.
Diet pop?
Yes.
In the morning?
In the morning.
Okay.
Then I'll find us something for lunch.
You fix something or you order something or you...
Depends on the day. Lately we've been fixing more of our food at home.
So if you fix, what do you fix?
Ramen noodles, cheeseburgers, sandwiches, like lunch meat sandwiches, chips.
Okay.
Stuff along that line.
Okay. And that's breakfast?
Yeah.
And then after that, what do you do?
Sometimes I'll take a nap or go sit in the front room and watch a movie.
You just woke up, you take a nap?
Yeah.
Okay. And what time do you go to bed?
I'm usually in bed by 7, 7:30.
So you sleep from 7:30 till 11 o'clock next day?
Mm-hmm.
You know how many hours is that?
Way too many.
You know, the fact that you sleep from 7 o'clock at night till 11 o'clock next day is very abnormal, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So you should get 8 hours sleep.
Okay.
Okay? And that's not healthy, but depression may be a factor in that too. If you're sleeping that much, and we need to address that.
I'm in therapy for my binge eating, and I see a psychiatrist for my mental health. So I've been working with them for a while, and it's helped me get quite a bit of it under control.
Well, I'm glad to hear that you're doing that, and I'm sure it has been a help to you. But regarding your issues with your eating habit, it doesn't appear that you have anything under control with that. So I'm guessing it has been more of help with other issues. Because with your medical history, I'm seeing in your file,
you had a lot of anxiety and depression in the past?
Yes. I still struggle with anxiety and depression, but it's more under control now than it's ever been.
Okay, but
I want you to see a psychotherapist before you go back. Is that something you can do?
We can't stay here longer. We need to go back, so can I do it with someone in Ohio?
I want you to do it with someone here, but we'll set up a video call for you. How does that sound?
Okay.
So
we'll set that up and let you know when that will be. So no matter what they do, do you understand this is all up to you?
Right.
So stay very focused with your eating habit. And if you do that and stick to the diet, you should easily be able to lose 40 pounds on the next one.
Okay.
And it's going to be very easy if you eat 3 times a day. You can even lose twice as much as that.
Okay.
But Krystal, what is motivating you to get healthy and change your life right now?
I want to live a better life. I want to go back to school and become a nurse. I want to take my son hiking. I want to do more with him. I want to be able to see him graduate and just be there for him.
Okay.
All that is good motivation, so use that to decide if food is worth more to you than those things, because if you don't change, none of that will happen.
It's all up to me now.
You got it.
All right, so we're going to see if we can get you on the right track. This is the stuff that you're going to read every day.
Okay.
And got the list of the food to avoid on the last page. This will give you some information about obesity and risk factor, understanding of metabolism, and healthy eating habit. So you read this every night.
Okay.
I think overall, Krystal has not been upfront with me about some things, particularly with the dynamic she has at home, because she's saying her family enables her. But she also said she ordered the food for the whole household. So she seems to be the one in the driver's seat with all that, and probably make the life miserable if they don't go along with what she wants them to bring her and what she tells them. So the family needs to not only learn not to give in to her, but Krystal is the one who is going to determine if that dynamic changes or not. The other things I'm concerned about is some of the mental and psych history I see in her medical history, on top of what it sounds like could be a significant degree of depression she may be struggling with, and that's been ongoing for many years. So I want her to talk with Dr. Paradise so he can get some insight to any issues we may need to focus on with her right now. Because depression is normal for someone who is 600 pounds and struggling with life. But if it is severe, then my concern is she may not have the ability to discipline herself for even a month, because one or two bad days can lead her so far off the rails that she messes up any progress she has made towards her weight loss goals. So if that's the case with Krystal, and what's behind her sleeping more than half the day, then we may be fighting a losing battle with her from the start, and things ultimately will go nowhere with her. So it's important we determine that. But we'll see how she does and what Dr. Paradise's thoughts are for her, and then determine where we go from there.
So let's see how we do in 4 weeks.
Okay.
Any questions?
Now, if I do lose the weight that you want or more, will I be eligible for surgery, or are you going to?
If you lose weight and change your eating habit, then we're going to approve you for weight loss surgery. We're going to proceed with checking your risk factor and see if you're going to be healthy enough to go to operation safely.
Okay.
And that's going to be what we need to do. But think of if you're successful, and then you need to think about moving down to Houston if you are serious about losing weight, because these 2.5 days coming in and 2.5 days going back is going to take toll on your body, and your body is not going to be tolerating that very well.
Right.
Okay. All right. We'll see you in 4 weeks, okay?
Okay. Sounds good.
If you need anything, give me a call.
Okay.
I hope we'll see you in 4 weeks and much later.
Me too.
All right. See you all later.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye.